We begin with the death of a cyclist near Wollongong, south of Sydney. The rider suffering serious head injuries when he crashed his bike while trying to avoid a swooping magpie. Grace Fitzgibbon is at the scene at Winona.
It's this section of path here at Nicholson Park in Winona where the 76-year-old cyclist veered off the path across the grass and collided with some wooden fence posts. Witnesses say he was cycling in a group of three others when he became distracted by a magpie that was swooping a female cyclist coming towards him in the opposite direction. They say he took his eyes off the path, focusing on the bird, and misinterpreted the corner.
The magpie is always swooping people here. They sort of said, oh, it must be the magpie.
The female cyclist who was being swooped was Nathan Foster's wife. The couple witnessed the 76-year-old hit the pavement and ran to help. When they realised he'd stopped breathing, they started CPR.
His eyes were off the track because he was concerned about the magpie swooping him, I think, and he just went over the fence and sustained some pretty bad injuries.
Despite wearing a helmet, the 76-year-old's head injuries were severe. Paramedics treated him at the scene before he was airlifted to St George Hospital in a critical condition. Sadly, he passed away there overnight. The incident is today sparking debate about the popular stretch of path. Locals say it's renowned for vicious magpie attacks and has caused problems for the last three seasons. We've contacted Wollongong Council to see what plans, if any, will be considered to ensure further protection here in the future.
Well, to Queensland now, where Harry Clark joins us from the scene of a devastating house fire north of Brisbane. Harry, the owner made a narrow escape.
Well, that's right, Mark. Fire crews were called here to this home at Petrie in Brisbane's north just before 8 o'clock when this house fire broke out. But by the time they got here, the house was well and truly engulfed in flames, and there really was not much that could be done to salvage any of the contents or the structure itself. Thankfully, the sole resident of the home managed to escape. He was inside the house at the time the fire started, but he got out and he also managed to rescue his pet cockatiel, which was a big relief to him. Now, he tells me that he's fallen on tough times at the moment. It's quite an unfortunate story. He's been unable to pay electricity bills, and because of that, he's been lighting his home with candles and gas lighters, and it was the candle that made the fire start and take hold, and the gas cylinders that exacerbated the flames. I'm told it was quite difficult by firefighters to get the blaze under control. Right now, he's actually just been led back onto the property. I don't think you see him right now, but fire crews are there with him trying to determine exactly where the blaze started and what caused it to spread so quickly. Just this front room here was where the candle was, I'm told, and then he had gas lighters in each of the rooms of the house. So the fire crews have told me that it definitely made circumstances quite difficult. They had to work very hard to get the blaze under control.
The crews worked pretty hard to bring the fire under control. There were a few gas cylinders inside that we had to be very careful of, but safety took priority and we managed to keep it under control.
Now, the residents told me that unfortunately he doesn't have home and contents insurance, so it's obviously a very difficult and will continue to be a very difficult time for him, although he assures me that he does have full support from neighbours and family and friends to get him through what's going to be a difficult time. Mark?
Harry Clark on the scene, thank you. Well, next to Melbourne, drivers have been forced to swerve out of the way of a speeding car that was going into oncoming traffic on a Melbourne highway. Sam Cucciara was there as the pursuit came to a crashing end.
This is where the high-speed police chase all came to a crashing end this morning. That is the white dual cab involved in this pursuit. We were actually on the way to Geelong for another story this morning when right here on the Princes Freeway, we've seen that car speeding towards us in the other direction in the emergency lane, and a convoy of police cars were not far behind. That car has then done a loop, and that's when police tell me they've performed a tactical manoeuvre, boxing that car in, forcing it to spin around and crash into the wire barrier. Police tell me that vehicle hit a number of other cars here on this busy road, and they believe the three offenders inside the ute were trying to steal other vehicles.
He's jumped on the wrong side of the road, followed by all these cop cars, come directly at me. It was absolutely scary as all hell. He was probably going about 80 on the wrong side of the road. He was in the emergency lane, swerving in and out. and directly at me. I had to swerve to miss him.
Police believe this ute was stolen from a service station a little earlier in the morning. This chase has caused traffic chaos in the area. As you can see there, plenty of cars are banked up with a number of the lanes here on the Princess Freeway shut to traffic. All three people inside the ute are right now in police custody.
Sam Cucciara there. Well, Volkswagen has agreed to pay out up to $127 million as part of a class action settlement with more than 100,000 Australian customers. The German carmaker was accused of misleading customers by advertising their diesel cars as environmentally friendly, despite vehicles being fitted with illegal emissions testing devices. Well, now to the impact on Australian petrol prices from the strikes against key Saudi Arabian oil facilities. Political reporter Fiona Willen joins us. Fee, what can we expect?
Mark, we can expect to pay more. An economist has told Nine News that prices are likely to climb by 5 to 10 cents a litre within a month. And that's because oil prices are now on their way up. Now, this drone attack was on the world's largest oil processing plant in Saudi Arabia. It's reduced its production by half. And so that's expected to hit the global supply. The Energy Minister, Angus Taylor, says the International Energy Agency, the IEA, has informed the government there's no immediate threat to Australia's fuel supplies. He was asked how many days worth of supply we have at the moment, and this is what he said.
By our definition, we're up around the 90-day mark. So, I mean, that is an appropriate level of stocks because that's what's obliged by the IEA.
We've raised previously our concern about fuel security. This is an issue for Australia and the government needs to deal with it.
Now, the Energy Minister was out today to speak about power prices. The Consumer Watchdog has released a report claiming that they've been coming down. It claims some households are saving between $130 and $430 a year, and that's due to new pricing laws. So these came into effect in July, putting a cap on what energy retailers can charge for standing offers. We'll be hearing a lot more on power prices this week. The government will soon introduce its Big Stick energy bill to Parliament, so that would enable it to force big energy companies to break up their assets to stop price gouging. Labor is still deciding whether it will back it. Mark?
Fiona Willen in Canberra, thank you. Well, a bullet has grazed a young man's face and a woman has been slashed with a knife in separate aggravated burglaries in Victoria. At Taylor's Lakes in Melbourne, a 21-year-old was helping his dad after they found three men trying to steal their car. The offenders fled after unsuccessfully kicking the door down and fired a shot which hit the son's cheek. 2 hours later, a Geelong woman woke to find two men in her home. She fought back and was slashed in the shoulder and hand. Both victims have been treated in hospital. And three teenagers are fighting for life following a crash in regional New South Wales, which killed a teenage passenger. The car they were travelling in lost control and crashed into a tree at Cowra in the state's central west yesterday afternoon. The 18-year-old driver, as well as a 17 and 19-year-old passenger, remain in critical but stable conditions. Well, staying in Victoria, the death of a man whose body was found inside a caravan is being treated as suspicious. Neary Tai with the latest.
Well, as you can see, a section of this street is still cordoned off as a crime scene after the discovery of a man's body here in Scoresby. It was around 5:30 last night when emergency services were called here to Borg Street. When they arrived, they found a 43-year-old man dead inside a caravan. Police have spent hours combing the crime scene, also chatting to neighbours to see if they heard any unusual sounds coming from the home. Now, we understand an elderly woman lives at the property with a number of her adult sons. The homicide squad is now looking after this investigation. Police haven't revealed how the man died, but at this stage they are treating his death as suspicious.
Retire there. Well, three of Australia's biggest airports are pocketing millions of dollars a year from parking fees, sending operating profits sky high. Sydney Airport earns a whopping $95 million in profit every year, followed by Melbourne at $84 million and Brisbane at $65 million. Well, one of our most famous exports, Olivia Newton-John, has said collaboration is the key to beating cancer in a speech at the second Australian Research Conference on the disease. The 70-year-old, who is fighting cancer for a third time, headlined a long list of speakers at the Melbourne event, which is exploring the next wave of cancer prevention, research and treatment.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.